Hello, and welcome to part 32 of FPC Series 90 Use Blender 2.7. In this video, we'll be talking about proportional editing. Now, what exactly is proportional editing? Well, it's a way of speeding up your modeling by being able to grab more than you have selected. Well, what do I mean by this? Well, sometimes when new users of Blender are modeling, they will have several objects in their scene. So I'll go ahead and press Shift-D to duplicate this cube. And then they'll grab something, but before they do, they'll press a key on their keyboard at random without even really knowing it. And then maybe they'll press G, and maybe they'll do some scrolling, and then suddenly other objects in their scene will move along with the one that they have selected. And this is very confusing, because I only have this one cube selected, and the other things around it are moving as well. And why is that happening? Well, the user accidentally pressed the O key on the keyboard, and I call this the O problem. Oh, that's what happened. What they actually enabled was proportional editing, and if you notice down here on the header of my 3D viewport, this little button turned blue. If you click it again, it turns off, and this is the proportional editing button. I'm going to go ahead and delete my second cube because I don't need it anymore. Yes, you can use proportional editing when you're in object mode, but the power of it comes when you're in edit mode. So I'm going to go ahead and press tab to go into edit mode, and I'll press W to subdivide this cube up with it all selected, and I'll turn my number of cuts up significantly higher to right about there, maybe one more, maybe 11 or so, maybe 9, okay. What proportional editing does is if you have something selected, in this case I'll select a vertice in the middle of the top of my cube, normally when I want to move part of my mesh when I'm modeling, let's say I'm modeling a character's head and I want to sort of push and pull the different parts out of his head, maybe I'm pushing his cheekbones or chin, or maybe the top of his head, a section of hair on his head, and I want to grab part of it and just move it. Well, moving just one vertice at a time would be a very tedious task. What if I could grab this one vertice and everything around it in sort of a nice even amount with a nice even fall off, in other words, kind of a feathered selection would allow me to move it like that? Well, that would be nice, and that's what proportional editing lets me do. So what I'll do here is, down here I'll click on this little button and I'll turn on enable proportional editing, or you can just press the O key on your keyboard on and off. With proportional editing turned on, if I press G and then I move my mouse, it's going to move more than I have selected. Well, how much? Why is it moving the entire cube and not just a few vertices around what I have selected? That's because I scrolled a lot, and when you scroll, it'll make your circle selection either bigger or smaller, depending on which direction that you scroll. And as you can see, I'm influencing a different amount or a different radius around the one vertice I have selected, which makes my selection bigger or smaller. Now, it's important to note that there are different kinds of falloff. So I'm going to go ahead and right-click to disable that. What falloff is the second option next to proportional editing, this blue button. If you have it turned off, if I disable it, it's not there, but if I turn it on to enabled, it's there. This falloff means the pattern or the amount of feather of falloff. In other words, how much, at what distance vertices around your selection or faces or edges around your selection are affected. Right now by default the falloff is smooth, so if I press G and then Z on my keyboard and move my mouse up, it kind of selects things less and less in a nice smooth pattern. So towards the edge of this circle on my screen right now, it's selecting ones less and less towards the edge of that circle in a nice kind of smooth pattern. If I change this, I'm going to go ahead and undo that with Control Z. If I change the falloff to, let's say, sharp, and I press G and then Z on my keyboard, it's not going to be the same pattern. The pattern of falloff is much sharper. In other words, the amount of influence on vertices as they go out towards the edge of that circle becomes much less, much more exponentially. So as you can see, it's not selecting ones around the outside nearly as much. Conversely, if I change the falloff type to constant, it's not going to fall off at all towards the edge of that circle. So if I press G and then Z now on my keyboard, it'll move all the vertices up that are within this circle, and I can scroll up and down, and as you can see, different ones are being moved as I make the circle bigger or smaller and I move my mouse up and down. All right, I'm going to go ahead and right click, and of course, I'll turn this back to smooth. You can use this not only to move things in your mesh, but you can also scale with this turned on. So as you can see, I can kind of warp my mesh. If I make this bigger, you'll see even more drastic results. You can squash and stretch your meshes. And of course, you can rotate as well to get a kind of neat warping effect. And that's all good and great. But where this really comes into play and where this is going to be helpful for you is when you're modeling something like a person's head or something organic and you want to push and pull things very quickly. So if I want to turn this cube into a more rounded shape, I could grab these corners and with proportional editing turned on, I could press G and I can move in the corners. And yes, I'm not going to be doing this in any kind of a detail, but as you can see, I can make a pretty interesting warp shape pretty quickly. Now there is one more very important option that I want to talk about in the proportional editing tool, and that is the connected option. What this means is, I'm going to go ahead and turn this off for a moment. If I select some of the faces on the side of this cube, let's say that I'm going to make a person's head. In this case, it's a very square person's head, or a very square head of a person. And let's say that this is the character's mouth. I'll go ahead and press I to insert it to kind of create a nice set of concentric circles or squares around the mouth. Then maybe I will press E to extrude, and then E again, and maybe I'll scale that up and maybe even push it back further, and then maybe I'll do a Control R for a loop cut and scale that to make it bigger. So if I go into wireframe view, I sort of have a mouth. Now, if I wanted to open and close the mouth, I'm gonna go ahead and go back into solid view. And maybe I grab some of these faces and I want to pull the mouth closed from the top down. Well, I'll turn on proportional editing with the O key on my keyboard, and then I'll press G and then Z on my keyboard. Well, of course I can scroll down to make it bigger, but it's going to move the bottom of the mouth as well. This is the, or one of the problems with the proportional editing tool is that if you just have it enabled, it's going to select everything within that circle radius. Well, what connected does is it only will select things that are directly connected in a straight line from your selection. So now if I turn this to connected, it will only select ones that are directly connected to the selection and not just within the circle radius. So if I press G and then Z on my keyboard, even though the bottom of the mouth is within my circle, it's not being affected because it's not directly connected to the faces that I currently have selected. So I can go ahead and close the mouth, or I could, let's say, grab an edge at the top of the mouth right there, and I could grab it and not have to worry about this bottom part of the mouth. Whereas if I had this turned on to enabled and I press G, it might move that area as well, as you can see. So these two different options have their places. Anyways, that's been a really quick introduction to the proportional editing tool. That'll be it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.